Hello.
Sweet. All right, everybody. How y'all doing?
Rolling.
All right, here we are. We're always trying to, you know, figure this out and make it work. It's kind of tight quarters here, but we got it. I think we're going to be able to do it. Mm-hmm. What do we got here? Oh, everything's working. Cheers, everybody. Happy Friday. I don't even know what the date is. Do you?
It is.
The 20th?
20th, yeah.
Oh, look at that. Sweet. We got Dr. Fauci with us here. He's got his mask on, and he says, flatten the curve. Come on.
Yeah, he's mask ready.
Mm-hmm. All right. You know what? Before we jump into it, oh, no, I'm going to break it out before we do this tune. We got all kinds of things going on tonight. My brother Lee, who's a, you know, I guess he is a modern day cowboy. He lives in California and he trains horses and he's got horses and rides them. And so he sent me a new Stetson hat last week. I'm going to have to debut that before we do one of these songs. What else? Oh, we're going to do some cooking later.
Yeah.
Because so, you know, I got to share with you, I think it was that Sunday we made venison meatloaf because we don't buy any red meat. You know, I'm a hunter. It was so insanely good. Wow. It was stupid good.
It was delicious.
And tonight, which is often the way we roll, tonight we're going to be making dinner with catfish that
we caught in Arkansas.
Yeah, we caught it in Arkansas with my brother Greg and Sheila and Brooke out there.
Mm-hmm.
So we still got some catfish left. We've eaten a ton of it, but we got some left. We're gonna throw that on the skillet. Along with Brussels sprouts that we grew. And they don't look very good. They're kind of sucking hind tit.
Yeah.
But they're little boogers, and some of them sprouted out. They kind of look like flowers.
Like, yeah. They never really got all close. Yeah. The leaves never got tight.
Yeah.
They're kind of like...
Some of them did, and some of them didn't, but they're still going to just taste so delicious.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, like that. So, we're going to jump off into some music. Sound like a plan? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to start and play something and see what happens. I don't know.
Love of heaven's older. Baby, you've got new hair.
A Jobim tune called How Insensitive. Also written by Vinicius de Moraes, who is another, you know, one of those people who invented, or if you
Antonio
will.
Antonio Carlos Jobim,
yes.
And Vinicius de Moraes.
Yeah.
Moraes?
Moraes. Moraes. De Moraes. Yeah, you know, they converted the samba into a bossa nova. And made it, the samba is like super, first of all, there's hundreds of variations of the samba. It's a faster groove, it's more complicated, and they made something accessible, and I hope they made a gazillion dollars, because, you know, they wrote these tunes like How Insensitive and Girl from Ipanema, and Quiet Nights, and blah, 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 and we're going to do a bunch of them.
Well, yeah, we're going to do two of them tonight.
The next one we're going to do was written by the great Billie Holiday.
Arthur Herzog Jr.
Yeah, and Arthur Herzog, a piano player. Billie Holiday was born in 1915 in Philadelphia.
Yeah.
Can you put Philadelphia, where all the insanity is happening at the moment?
Hey.
Okay, we won't go. Philadelphia, the great Billie Holiday. This is one of her. She had a few famous tunes. This is one of the most. Here we go.
Empty pockets still at the bank, the
Thank you.
I can only hope too. I'm assuming this is all happening. How do we know that we're broadcasting?
Well, it says finish.
Oh, okay.
And Phyllis hasn't messaged either.
Okay,
of us.
Then I guess we're gone. You know, Phyllis is she's our watchdog. She's keeping an eye on things and making sure it's all working for us, and mm-hmm. we sure are grateful and thankful for that. Oh man, look at this. Well, let's jump into this thing. I got to figure out which pickups I'm using. So I got to share with you, I'm playing again tonight this incredible guitar made by Ian Reddick. And I know last week I put his stuff up and I was tight for time and I didn't get it, but I'm going to do a special post this weekend, soon. About this guitar with all of Ian's information. It's the most revolutionary thing that's happened in electric guitars in decades and decades and decades. I mean, it's insane. So tonight I have humbucker pickups in it, so it's got like a nice fat Gibson sound to it, and that's what I'm using right now. I'll find something here before too long to change it out. You know, you just pop this thing out the back, bang, the pickups come out, and I put another set in. Ian, this man, what a home run. I can't believe it. And I love Ian because I've known him. He was a student of mine at Sarah Lawrence College. Wow. He's doing something revolutionary. Check him out. I will post his stuff on a separate post. Ian Reddick. Look him up on the internet.
Phyllis said, sounds good.
We like that. I do need to get, before I get out of here, I'm going to get one of his business cards, you know, and dial it, let you know. Anyway, we're going to jump into this. This is a funky little spot in the middle of nowhere in Stafford, Kansas. And I don't know, they got some business going on there. It's at Elroy's. We're going to do a song about Elroy's. Mm-hmm. Cheers, everybody. Woo! Woo! Yeah, so Uriah's going to be playing leg.
Electric leg.
You know, that's what we're calling it. She's going to play leg on this. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because I'm not
a percussion
player, so we play
lick. Oh, there's a kind of digging that sound. Uh-huh. Thank you. Making it up as we go.
Yep.
I'm definitely making that shit up. Lord have mercy.
We do.
We're going to jump off into something different here. We ain't never done this one before. And I have to say, this is pretty funny. I have played this song before.
I learned this last night.
Yeah, I probably have sang it a time or two over the years, but for whatever reasons, my mother keeps telling me for like the last however many months, you really should be doing this song. This
That's
is
funny.
A song that you should be singing.
I got another song for you.
And what's that?
I said I got another song for you.
Oh,
this is
good.
On the road again, on the curb again.
Ah!
No, I'm serious.
We should write it.
No.
Is it somebody already write it?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
It's like,
title gone. All right, well, we're going to jump into this. This is a Willie Nelson song, but I told you I got to share this because hang on 1 second.
On the curb again.
Look at this, man. My brother Lee sent me this hat. He sent it to me for my birthday.
On the curb again.
Oh.
On the curb again. That's the song.
Wow.
That's how it goes.
I wish we had written it.
Yeah.
I guess we better do it. Anyway, this is a brim that Lee gave to me, and I'm going to wear it when we do this song.
Nice.
And I'm going to try to get some of this song right, because I don't know what he... I don't know if I need this for the acoustic guitar. All right, somewhere I had picks up here, I'd lose my ass if it wasn't attached. There's a guitar pick right there. Yeah, here we go. We're going to do this.
I'm scared.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. Road again, like a band of gypsy, we go down the highway with the best of friends, insisting that the world be turning our way. It's on the road again. We just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. Because, you know, we normally are on the road a fair amount, and shit, we haven't been on the road for, what is it now, 9 months or something, and I don't think we're going to be on the road anytime soon.
Coronavirus!
Yeah, that damn pandemic, I'll tell you what,
Cheers to New Zealand, though. They got their shit together, and now everybody's out again because they shut their borders. Like, people were wearing masks. They were staying at home. It was great. Now, New Zealand, they're open. Not the borders, but open for people.
Some countries did the right thing. Not us. Okay. Anyway, cheers. Boy, ain't that a fine-looking brim right there now?
Woo!
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a nice feel.
Yeah, it's made out of buffalo. Yeah. Anyway, okay.
Nice.
Thanks, Lee. My brother Lee sent that
like
to me.
I'd like to eat a buffalo.
Oh, buffalo's delicious.
I've never had one.
Mm-hmm.
We should do that.
Yeah.
At some point. We had frog legs. He introduced me to frog legs. I've had...
Oh, that's something
squirrels.
Uncle Greg and I do. That's our plan when it gets warm again. We're going to catch a bunch of big bullfrogs and fry those up, man. Those are delicious.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now we're jumping into this is a song that, you know, I keep saying the title and trying to believe it. So it's called What a Wonderful World. You know.
It is a wonderful world.
It's pretty damn good.
Shit, but when you look out your window and you see just beautiful nature, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Even when it's shitty, it's good. Yeah, I know. Even when it's shitty, it's good.
Even if it's raining.
Yeah, man. All right, well, I don't think I need it for this one either, because I'm going to play some acoustic, but you can use a little bit there. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, this is, you know, I know he didn't write it, but Louis Armstrong recorded it. And of course, as you know, Louis Armstrong changed music forever. It would not be the same to this day had there not been Louis Armstrong. So we thank him for that. And,
we're
going to do that song. Here we go.
I see trees of green, riot roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
I see skies of blue, clouds of white, bright blessed day, dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Shaking hands,
how do you do?
They'll really say it.
What a wonderful world.
Oh, yes, I think to myself.
What a wonderful world.
It's a wonderful world, even with all the bullshit.
That's a sweetie right there now. Oh man, I tell you what. That's a beauty. Got to love it. What do we got now? Oh, we're gonna have some fun now. I think I'll play electric on this. I don't know, even know why, but it seems like the right thing to do. I don't know. I gotta get that pick out of there. We got a pick hanging out there where it don't belong. Can you slide that over this way? Is my stuff on there?
No. What do you mean? The lyrics that you sing? Of course the lyrics that you sing are on there.
All right, well, let's just have it right in the middle and we're going to share a little bit. Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know how much I hate that.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you. dab me. Oh, is for the only one I'll see.
Quick moment here to tune up on this incredible guitar that Ian Reddick sent to me. It's unbelievable. Before the night's over, I'm going to pull those pickups out and show you what we got. It's just cool as hell. I can't believe that somebody hadn't thought of it up to this point and put it out on a large scale, but that's what Ian's going to do. Yeah, he's producing these guitars. Mm-hmm. All right.
All right. Oh, well, you smack your lips a little bit less. I feel a lot better about my life.
I hear you. Me too.
I have OCD. Every time somebody like really goes like, I have to like do this. Ready? All right, I'll show you. And it looks really stupid too. And then I dig at my ears.
Okay. Yeah, you got it right. You got to do your compulsions. Uh-huh. I know. I usually don't do that. The only thing I do once in a while is scratch my ass. Maybe that's too much information. Okay. We're going to jump into this. We've just recorded this, and it sounds so good. It's insane. I'm telling you. We didn't write it, but a New Jersey person did.
Yep.
It's a cover of Halsey's tune, Gasoline, and we're going to do
it. Yeah, that's right. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Are you insane like me? But in vain like me? Bought a $100 bottle of champagne like me? Just to pour the whole bottle down the drain like me. Would you use your water bill to draw the same like me? Are you high enough without them every day like me? Do you tell yourself about to entertain like me? Do people whisper about you on the train like me? Seeing that you shouldn't waste your pretty face like me. And all the people say you can't wake up. This is not a dream. You're part of a machine. You are not a human being. Face all made up living on the screen. Low on self-esteem, so you run on gasoline.
Special one.
rains like me? Are you strange like me? Lighting matches just to swallow up the flame like me. You call yourself a dying hurricane like me. Pointing fingers, yes, you'll never take the blame like me. And all the people say you can't wake up. This is not a dream. You're part of a machine. You are not a human being.
Soon we're going to be sharing it with y'all, and I'm going to play something out front. We're going to jump into this next one. We're playing just a bunch of sweet tunes that we love to play, and here we go. Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Was only a quiet songs by quiet streams, and a window looking on a mountain down the sea. Lonely, this is where I want to be. Here with you, so close to me, to the final flicker of the last ember. I was lost and lonely, but only thing I was only, oh dear, to be dean of existence, oh my love. But the melody
Okay, what do we got here?
Getting old and cold.
Uh-huh, yeah. Whew. That was rough, let me tell you. That hurt. Okay. How's this song go?
Well, sometimes thank you. I go by myself.
Wow, I gotta have a drink on that one.
Oh, y'all, that last one. Was wow. That Quiet Nights we just did? I'm losing my mind so fast.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that was Quiet Nights we just did, where I messed up all the lyrics, but...
Oh, it was so beautiful, it didn't matter.
Hilarious.
Yeah. I had one of those moments, you know, sometimes like, you turn just right, and somehow there's like a nerve
yes,
or something
that
gets
exactly
pinched
what
in
you're
your neck.
About.
And we're like,
no,
I mean,
I
almost
exactly
blacked
where
out.
Like,
yeah. Yeah,
yeah,
literally.
You almost whoa. Feel like you're going to become paralyzed.
Yeah, it was rough.
Yeah,
that hurt.
Exactly what you're talking about. Mm-hmm. The last one, Quiet Nights, Quiet Stars, that was the second Jill Beam tune.
Yeah.
This one's a co-written by Gene Lees.
I don't even know who
the last one was co-written by two people, so.
All right.
This one's just co-written by one. It's two people. The last one was three. That's what I meant to say.
Sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. Ooh, and I think of all the things what you're doing. In my head, I feel a picture. Cause since I've come along, well, my body's been missing. It's your ginger hair. Why don't you come on over? shopping anywhere. Change the color of your hair. Are you dizzy? Ooh, did you have to pay the fine? You were dodging all the time.
So I'm going to do this maybe at this moment. I don't know why.
Maybe at this moment.
You know what? I'll do it before on the last tune. I'm going to switch out pickups just so folks can see this crazy guitar.
Okay.
Crazy guitar.
The crazy guitar.
All right. Well, we're going to put it on stand for the moment here. And I'm going to slide in. And I'm trying to get acquainted with what I got to do here, which is always a hell of a challenge. Okay. Yeah, all right. Well, I got to just say, so I wrote this tune. This is a tune about my dad. Mm-hmm. I don't know if my brother Greg, he might be traveling. He might be going hunting or something, but I don't know. Anyway, you know, growing up, he was about as hard as they get. Harder than nails.
Military man.
I mean, you know, he's one of those guys. He was working in the fields when he was 4 years old, working out 10 hours a day. And I mean, I've seen him shoot nails into his hand with a nail gun and just not even flinch and pull out a pair of pliers and pull it out and keep on working the whole day.
Oh, yeah, but you do the same thing, so don't say that.
Well, I ain't got quite that much grit, but.
You do.
Anyway.
Remember the hook? Through your thumb or whatever?
I don't know, but
or
I'm telling you.
Greg, he's got a lot of grit.
Yeah, the old man's tougher than hell. He built a cabin up in the mountains 10,000 feet with a chainsaw and a Jeep when he was 70 years old. Shit, I couldn't do that on my best day. Anyway, Pop, I know they don't have no internet. And
Grandpa.
Yeah, he can't be hearing this or seeing it, but love you. He's a badass.
Love you.
This is a thing called Hansible Working Man. And when I played in Kansas, I got to say, I sent us out to Claire Donnelly. He had us out there, Shadowland. And man, it was just great to see him and my dad sitting together. And we did this song out there. Of course, Claire passed away maybe only a year after that. And
wow.
We miss him, but hands were working, man. He's another one. And those cats, you know, from that generation, those were working men right there.
Yeah.
Me, I'm a loafer. I loaf for a living.
You are not. You're a hard worker.
Yeah, but it's a different kind of work. I kind of just sit on my ass and mess around.
But yeah, you got a lot of mental fucking work.
Anyway, I'm going to try to get some of this. I feel a soft touch, skin split and rough. I feel the gentle power of a man tall and tough. I'm a baby in the crib, now he's walking me to school. He had hands like a giant, calloused from hammers and tools. I'm holding the hands of a working man. Making a living and doing the best he can. Taught me how to work, taught me how to hunt. It taught me how to fish and how to drive a truck. It taught me to be honest and not cheat or lie. 'Cause with these hands of steel, he tan your backside. I'm feeling the hands of a working man. He's making a living and doing the best he can. As a young man, I was defiant, ornery and loud. I did so many things that made him less than proud. Still, he gave me all the things, all the things he never had. Made tremendous sacrifice. Yeah, that's my dad. I'm feeling the hands of a working man. He's making a living and doing the best he can. As his way, sometimes I don't understand. I'm feeling the hand of a working man. He stood beside me through tough times, troubles and being a fool, through fights, drugs, arrest, and getting kicked out of school. He supported me through college and the path that I chose. In marriage and raising a family, I needed his direction. God knows I'm looking at the hands of a working man. The man is living and doing the best he can. He has his way, I don't always understand. I'm looking at the hand of a working man. The years have gone by, and the fire in him subside. He's withered down and frail, and it makes me want to cry. But he's more a man than I'll ever be. He's a giant, the biggest man to me. I'm holding hands of a working man. His man is living, he's doing the best he can. He has his way, now I understand. Well, I didn't expect for that to happen. I got a little choked up there.
Yeah, you got a little emotional.
Yeah, that's my dad. You know, he's a badass.
I think you're a badass.
Yeah. Oh, man. All right, everybody. Thanks for being with us. We're going to do one more tune. Send you out on a fun note. I'm going to try to remember how it goes and get some of it. And then we're going to move over to the stove and we're going to throw some stuff on it, man. Oh, boy. Look out. Look out. Yeah, that little Arkansas catfish with some Jersey raised Brussels sprouts.
Oh, yeah.
Some.
This last song is Walking on Sunshine. We ain't trying to keep you people too long. We getting right into it. Yeah.
Oh, wait.
I'll show you what we're cooking.
Wait, I said I was going to do it. Check this out. So I got humbuckers in this. Sounds like a Les Paul's fat, sweet. It's just ridiculous. Just watch this right here now. I'm going to pop this out. Bang. Oh, well, it's stuck in there. This one's a little tight. Holy cow. That never happened before.
There it goes.
Okay, we popped her out. Humbuckers. Yep. Now I'm going to... I mean, it's kind of amazing because Ian made that part without the guitar. He sent it to me, and the fact that it even fits is unbelievable. Now I'm going to pop in a nice little set of single coil pickups and try to have some fun with that. Oh, look at that. Oh, they just slid right in. Oh, let's see what we got. Oh, man, look at that. I like it. Yeah. Oh, Ryan's bringing the energy right there. Here we go.
Sunshine, baby, yeah. Woo! I'm walking on sunshine.
stock feels good. You're in charge of the camera. Oh,
hold on.
Peel that off of there and bring them into the kitchen. We're moving into the kitchen. I'm going to start this iron skillet. Woo! We're going to put some lights in here. Uh-huh.
Oh, so here we have catfish.
Oh, catfish. And I know it looks like they've been blackened, which I love. But that's actually a chili lime seasoning. And here is the General's. Oh, so check it out. That's homemade crushed red pepper because it comes from, check this out. Let's bring this out here and show them these colorful things. Can we see what we're doing? Let me see. Oh, look at that. Okay, you can see the tray. Yeah, so check it out. Those are cayenne peppers, red ones. These didn't make it. They weren't able to ripen, but they're still tasty.
I'm trying to get this. It's like you turn it one way and it goes the other way and I have to get used to that.
Yeah. And these are habaneros over here that I've dried.
You do it. I need you to hold the phone.
Well, I can't
see it. I can't do it. I'm so bad at it, guys. I'm so bad at this.
I'm just pointing her down there. There you are. Look at that. Look at that right there. Okay, we got it. Ah, look at those habanero. I know. I'm doing this. Okay. Is everybody getting dizzy out there?
Yeah. There we go.
So yeah, those are habaneros I've dried. These are ones that didn't turn because it got cold. But then we make our own crushed pepper, you know? And so there's the catfish. Hopefully you can see it. I can't tell what the hell we're looking at. But little catfish. We got the skillet going over here. Let's get some light on the skillet. Oh yeah. We're just making this up as we go. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? People. Okay, so here we're going to jump down here. Oh, look at that. Hey, Araya, grab the garlic over there. Well, I can't tell what the hell we're doing. I think we're looking at something. Splash some garlic in there. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, we're going to let that heat up. I know, I like catfish when you bread it and fry it. We're trying to do it a little healthier tonight. Uh-huh. I can only hope that you can see this because I don't know what the hell I'm doing with this camera.
Oh, yeah, they can see it.
Okay. All right. That's heating up nicely. Oh, a little extra garlic. Oh, you got to love it. Okay. Hate to tell you this, Rye. You're going to have to be in charge of the phone.
All right.
Phone.
Well,
we're going to slap some.
Slap the catfish in there.
All right, you slap the catfish in.
All right, the rice is done. Got that.
Oh, look at that. We got, hang on, little yellow rice. Oh, that's going to be so tasty. We got some black beans cooking over here.
Over to the front burner. Woo! Brussels sprouts.
There's the Brussels sprouts. Look at that. Oh, man, we grew those right out back. Oh,
they don't look so great, but they probably will taste good.
Oh, those are going to be so good we won't be able to stand it. All right, we got to get the catfish in here before it's too late. Slap them in there. Be quick about it. Pop them in. Oh, well, I'd put them down the other way.
Well, I'm going to season the other side.
Okay. Slip her right in there. All right, get a little bit of that lime seasoning. Nope, not.
Ah!
Over there, right there.
Okay.
Okay.
Right. I'm moody because I just got off from, being a bitch to everyone.
Oh, man, that's looking good. That's good. Yeah, you got it. Uh-huh. Okay, good. Don't get too carried away. Lord have mercy. Oh, I'm telling you, that catfish, Arkansas catfish, is going to be so good. We got the black beans, we got the yellow rice, Brussels sprouts we grew out back, rice seasoning it on up. Oh. All right, people. Hey, thanks for being with us. Where's
Arise? We love you guys. Arise. I'm sorry I've been kind of an asshole.
Oh, that's what we do. That's what we do. It's okay to do that now. Anyway, man, thanks for being with us on Quarantunes. We love
Thank
it.
Thank you. We love you guys.
We're going to keep doing it as long as we can do it. And be safe out there. We love the comments. We'll be checking in on it. Have a nice weekend, folks. See ya.
Bye.
Bye.